This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Microsoft Corporation, Microsoft, Feet, commonly referred to as Microsoft or MS, is an American multinational technology company headquartered in Redmond, Washington, that develops, manufactures, licenses, supports and sells computer software, consumer electronics and personal computers and services. Its best known software products are the Microsoft Windows line of operating systems, Microsoft Office Office Suite, and Internet Explorer and Edge web browsers. Its flagship hardware products are the Xbox video game consoles and the Microsoft Surface tablet lineup. As of 2011, it was the world's largest software maker by revenue, and one of the world's most valuable companies. Microsoft was founded by Paul Allen and Bill Gates on April 4, 1975, to develop and sell basic interpreters for the Altair 8800. It rose to dominate the personal computer operating system market with MS-DOS in the mid-1980s, followed by Microsoft Windows, the company's 1986 initial public offering IPO, and subsequent rise in its share price, created 3 billionaires and an estimated 12,000 millionaires among Microsoft employees since the 1990s. It has increasingly diversified from the operating system market and has made a number of corporate acquisitions. In May 2011, Microsoft acquired Skype Technologies for $85 billion in its largest acquisition up to. June 2016 bought LinkedIn for $262 billion. As of 2015, Microsoft is market dominant in the IBM PC-compatible operating system market and the Office software suite market, although it has lost the majority of the overall operating system market to Android. The company also produces a wide range of other software for desktops and servers, and is active in areas including internet search with Bing, the video game industry with the Xbox, Xbox 360 and Xbox One consoles, the digital services market through MSN, and mobile phones via the operating systems of Nokia's former phones and Windows Phone OS. In June 2012, Microsoft entered the personal computer production market for the first time, with the launch of the Microsoft Surface, a line of tablet computers, with the acquisition of Nokia's devices and services division to form Microsoft Mobile. The company re-entered the smartphone hardware market, after its previous attempt, Microsoft Kin, which resulted from their acquisition of Danger Inc. The word Microsoft is a portmanteau of microcomputer and software. Contents 1 History 11-1972-1984, founding and company beginnings 12-1984-1994, Windows and Office 13-1995-2007, Internet and the 32-bit era 14-2007-2011, Windows Vista, Mobile, and Windows 7 15-2011-2014, Rebranding, Windows 8, Surface and Nokia devices. 16-2014 present, Windows 10 Minecraft, HoloLens 161 Corporate Affairs 162 Products 163 Services 2 Businesses 21 Windows Division, Server and Tools, Online Services Division 22 Business Division 23 Entertainment and Devices Division 24 Future Decoded 3 Corporate Affairs 31 Board of Directors 32 Financial 33 Marketing 34 Layoffs 35 United States Government 4 Corporate Identity Entity 41 Corporate Culture 42 Environment 43 Headquarters 44 Flagship Stores 45 Logo 46 Sponsorship 5 See also 6 References 7 External links. History Main Articles, History of Microsoft, History of Microsoft Windows, and Timeline of Microsoft 1972-1984, Founding and Company Beginnings. Paul Allen L. and Bill Gates R. on October 19, 1981, in a sea of PCs after signing a pivotal contract. IBM called Microsoft in July 1980 inquiring about programming languages for its upcoming PC line, 228 after failed negotiations with another company. IBM gave Microsoft a contract to develop the OS for the new line of PCs. Paul Allen and Bill Gates, childhood friends with a passion for computer programming, sought to make a successful business utilizing their shared skills. In 1972 they founded their first company, named Traf O Data, which offered a rudimentary computer that tracked and analyzed automobile traffic data. Allen went on to pursue a degree in computer science at Washington State University, later dropping out of school to work at Honeywell. Gates began studies at Harvard. The January 1975 issue of Popular Electronics featured micro-instrumentation and telemetry systems's MIT's Altair 8800 microcomputer. Allen suggested that they could program a basic interpreter for the device. After a call from Gates claiming to have a working interpreter, MIT's requested a demonstration since they didn't actually have one. Allen worked on a simulator for the Altair while Gates developed the interpreter. Although they developed the interpreter on a simulator and not the actual device, the interpreter worked flawlessly when they demonstrated the interpreter to MIT's in Albuquerque, New Mexico in March 1975. MIT's agreed to distribute it, marketing it as Altair Basic 108, 112-114. They officially established Microsoft on April 4, 1975, with Gates as the CEO. Allen came up with the original name of Microsoft, as recounted in a 1995 Fortune magazine article. In August 1977, the company formed an agreement with ASCII magazine in Japan, resulting in its first international office, ASCII Microsoft. The company moved to a new home in Bellevue, Washington in January 1979. Microsoft entered the OS business in 1980 with its own version of Unix, called Xenix. However, it was MS-DOS that solidified the company's dominance after negotiations with Digital Research failed. IBM awarded a contract to Microsoft in November 1980 to provide a version of the CP.M OS, which was set to be used in the upcoming IBM personal computer IBM PC. For this deal, Microsoft purchased a CP.M clone called 86D OS from Seattle Computer Products, branding it as MS-DOS, which IBM rebranded to PC-DOS following the release of the IBM PC in August 1981. Microsoft retained ownership of MS-DOS since IBM copyrighted the IBM PC BIOS. Other companies had to reverse engineer it in order for non-IBM hardware to run as IBM PC compatibles, but no such restriction applied to the operating systems due to various factors, such as MS-DOS available software selection. Microsoft eventually became the leading PC operating systems vendor. 210. The company expanded into new markets with the release of the Microsoft Mouse in 1983, as well as with a publishing division named Microsoft Press. 232. Paul Allen resigned from Microsoft in 1983 after developing Hodgkin's disease. 1984-1994, Windows and Office. Windows 10 was released on November 20, 1985 as the first version of the Microsoft Windows line timeline of Windows while jointly developing a new OS with IBM in 1984, OS 2. Microsoft released Microsoft Windows, a graphical extension for MS-DOS, on November 20, 1985, 242-243, 246. Microsoft moved its headquarters to Redmond on February 26, 1986, and on March 13 the company went public. The ensuing rise in the stock would make an estimated 4 billionaires and 12,000 millionaires from Microsoft employees due to the partnership with IBM. In 1990, the Federal Trade Commission set its eye on Microsoft for possible collusion. It marked the beginning of over a decade of legal clashes with the U.S. government. Microsoft released its version of OS 2 to original equipment manufacturers OEMs on April 2, 1987, 243-244. Meanwhile, the company was at work on a 32-bit OS, Microsoft Windows NT, using ideas from OS 2. It shipped on July 21, 1993, with a new modular kernel and the Win32 Application Programming Interface API, making porting from 16-bit MS-DOS-based Windows easier. Once Microsoft informed IBM of NT, the OS 2 partnership deteriorated. In 1990, Microsoft introduced its Office suite, Microsoft Office. The software bundled separate Office productivity applications, such as Microsoft Word and Microsoft Excel. 301. On May 22, Microsoft launched Windows 30 with a streamlined user interface, graphics, and improved protected mode capability for the Intel 386 processor. Both Office and Windows became dominant in their respective areas. Novell, a Word competitor from 1984 to 1986, filed a lawsuit years later claiming that Microsoft left part of its APIs undocumented in order to gain a competitive advantage. On July 27, 1994, the U.S. Department of Justice Antitrust Division filed a competitive impact statement that said, in part, beginning in 1988, and continuing until July 15, 15, 1994, Microsoft induced many OEMs to execute anti-competitive per-processor licenses under a per-processor license. An OEM pays Microsoft a royalty for each computer it sells containing a particular microprocessor, whether the OEM sells the computer with a Microsoft operating system or a non-Microsoft operating system in effect, the royalty payment to Microsoft when no Microsoft product is being used acts as a penalty, or tax, on the OEM's use of a competing PC operating system. Since 1988, Microsoft's use of per-processor licenses has increased. 1995-2007, Internet and the 32-bit era. Bill Gates giving his deposition in 1998 for the United States v. Microsoft trial following Bill Gates's internal Internet tidal wave memo. On May 26, 1995, Microsoft began to redefine its offerings and expand its product line into computer networking and the World Wide Web. The company released Windows 95 on August 24, 1995, featuring preemptive multitasking, a completely new user interface with a novel start button, and 32-bit compatibility. Similar to NT, it provided the Win32 API. 20 Windows 95 came bundled with the online service MSN, which was at first intended to be a competitor to the Internet, and for OEM's Internet Explorer, a web browser. Internet Explorer was not bundled with the retail Windows 95 boxes because the boxes were printed before the team finished the web browser, and instead was included in the Windows 95 Plus pack. Branching out into new markets in 1996, Microsoft and NBC Universal created a new 24/7 cable news station, MSNBC. Microsoft created Windows CE 10, a new OS designed for devices with low memory and other constraints, such as personal digital assistants. In October 1997, the Justice Department filed a motion in the Federal District Court, stating that Microsoft violated an agreement signed in 1994 and asked the court to stop the bundling of Internet Explorer with Windows 323-324. In 1996, Microsoft released Windows CE, a version of the operating system meant for personal digital assistants and other tiny computers. Bill Gates handed over the CEO position on January 13, 2000, to Steve Ballmer, an old college friend of Gates and employee of the company since 1980, creating a new position for himself as Chief Software Architect. 111-228. Various companies including Microsoft formed the Trusted Computing Platform Alliance in October 1999 to, among other things, increase security and protect intellectual property through identifying changes in hardware and software. Critics decry the alliance as a way to enforce indiscriminate restrictions over how consumers use software, and over how computers behave, a form of digital rights management. For example, the scenario where a computer is not only secured for its owner, but also secured against its owner as well. On April 3, 2000, a judgment was handed down in the case of United States v. Microsoft, calling the company an abusive monopoly. It settled with the U.S. Department of Justice in 2004. On October 25, 2001, Microsoft released Windows XP, unifying the mainstream and NT lines under the NT codebase. The company released the Xbox later that year, entering the game console market dominated by Sony and Nintendo. In March 2004, the European Union brought antitrust legal action against the company, citing it abused its dominance with the Windows OS, resulting in a judgment of €497. Gates retired from his role as Chief Software Architect on June 27, 2008, a decision announced in June 2006, while retaining other positions related to the company in addition to being an advisor for the company on key projects. Azure Services Platform, the company's entry into the cloud computing market for Windows, launched on October 27, 2008. On February 12, 2009, Microsoft announced its intent to open a chain of Microsoft-branded retail stores, and on October 22, 2009, the first retail Microsoft store opened in Scottsdale, Arizona. The same day the first store opened, Windows 7 was officially released to the public. Windows 7's focus was on refining Vista with ease-of-use features and performance enhancements, rather than a large reworking of Windows. As the smartphone industry boomed beginning in 2007, Microsoft struggled to keep up with its rivals Apple and Google in providing a modern smartphone operating system. As a result, in 2010, Microsoft revamped their aging flagship flagship mobile operating system, Windows Mobile, replacing it with the new Windows Phone OS, along with a new strategy in the smartphone industry that had Microsoft working more closely with smartphone manufacturers, such as Nokia, and to provide a consistent user experience across all smartphones using Microsoft's Windows Phone OS. It used a new user interface design language, codenamed Metro, which prominently used simple shapes, topography and iconography, and the concept of minimalism. Microsoft, as a founding member of the Open Networking Foundation, started on March 23, 2011. Other founding companies include Google, HP Networking, Yahoo, Verizon, Deutsche Telekom and 17 other companies. The nonprofit organization is focused on providing support for a new cloud computing initiative called Software-Defined Networking. The initiative is meant to speed innovation through simple software changes in telecommunications networks, wireless networks, data centers and other networking areas. 2011-2014, rebranding, Windows 8, Surface and Nokia devices. Start screen on Windows 81 Surface Pro 3, part of the Surface series of laptops by Microsoft. Following the release of Windows Phone, Microsoft underwent a gradual rebranding of its product range throughout 2011 and 2012. The corporation's logos, products, services, and websites adopted the principles and concepts of the Metro design language. Microsoft previewed Windows 8, an operating system designed to power both personal computers and tablet computers, in Taipei in June 2011. A developer preview was released on September 13, and was replaced by a consumer preview on February 29, 2012. On May 31, 2012, the preview version was released on June 18, 2012. Microsoft unveiled the Surface, the first computer in the company's history to have its hardware made by Microsoft, on June 25. Microsoft paid $12 billion to buy the social network Yammer on July 31, 2012. Microsoft launched the Outlook.com webmail service to compete with Gmail on September 4, 2012. Microsoft released Windows Server 2012 in July 2012, Microsoft sold its 50% stake in MSNBC.com, which it had run as a joint venture with NBC since 1996. On October 1, Microsoft announced its intention to launch a news operation, part of a new-look MSN, at the time of the Windows 8 launch. That was later in the month. On October 26, 2012, Microsoft launched Windows 8 and the Microsoft Surface. 3 days later, Windows Phone 8 was launched to cope with the potential for an increase in demand for products and services. Microsoft opened a number of holiday stores across the U.S. to complement the increasing number of bricks and mortar Microsoft stores that opened in 2012. On March 29, 2013, Microsoft launched a patent tracker, the Kinect, a motion sensing input device made by Microsoft and designed as a video game controller, which was first introduced in November 2010, was upgraded for the 2013 release of the 8th generation Xbox One video game console. Kinect's capabilities were revealed in May 2013. The new Kinect uses an ultra-wide 1080p camera. It can function in the dark due to an infrared sensor. It employs higher-end processing power and new software. It can distinguish between fine movements such as a thumb movements, and the device can determine a user's heart rate by looking at his/her face. Microsoft filed a patent application in 2011 that suggests that the corporation may use the Kinect camera system to monitor the behavior of television viewers as part of a plan to make the viewing experience more interactive. On July 19, 2013. Microsoft stocks suffered its biggest one-day percentage sell-off since the year 2000 after its fourth-quarter report raised concerns among the investors on the poor showings of both Windows 8 and the Surface tablet, with more than 11 percentage points declining. Microsoft suffered a loss of more than $32 billion for the 2010 fiscal year. Microsoft had five product divisions: Windows Division, Server and Tools, Online Services Division, Microsoft Business Division and Entertainment and Devices Division, Xbox One Console, Xbox 360 Kinect Sensor. John W. Thompson has been appointed the chairman of Microsoft, taking over from Bill Gates on September 3, 2013. Microsoft agreed to buy Nokia's mobile unit for $7 billion also in 2013. Amy Hood became the CFO of Microsoft. The Alliance for Affordable Internet A4AI was launched in October 2013, and Microsoft was part of the coalition of public and private organizations that also included Facebook, Intel, and Google, led led by World Wide Web inventor Tim Berners-Lee, the A4AI seeks to make internet access more affordable so that access is broadened in the developing world, where only 31% of people are online. Google will help to decrease internet access prices so that they fall below the UN Broadband Commission's worldwide target of 5% of monthly income, in line with the maturing PC business. In July 2013, Microsoft announced that it would reorganize the business into four new business divisions by function. Operating system, apps, cloud and devices. All previous divisions will be diluted into new divisions without any workforce cut. 2014 present, Windows 10 Minecraft, HoloLens. A depiction of a Microsoft HoloLens user navigating the shell, with an application window on the left, and the start menu on the right. Corporate affairs. On February 4, 2014, Steve Ballmer stepped down as CEO of Microsoft and was succeeded by Satya Nadella, who previously led Microsoft's cloud and enterprise division. On the same day, John W. Thompson took on the role of chairman, with Bill Gates stepping down from the position, while continuing to participate as a technology advisor. On April 25, 2014, Microsoft acquired Nokia Devices and Services for $72 billion. The new subsidiary was renamed Microsoft Mobile Oy in May 2016. The company announced it will lay off 1,850 workers, taking an impairment and restructuring charge of $950 million. During the previous summer of 2015, the company wrote down $76 billion related to its mobile phone business and fired 7,800 employees from those operations. On September 15, 2014, Microsoft acquired the video game development company Mojang, best known for its wildly popular flagship game Minecraft, for $25 billion products. On January 21, 2015, Microsoft announced the release of their first interactive whiteboard, Microsoft Surface Hub, part of the Surface family. On July 29, 2015, Microsoft released the next version of the Windows operating system, Windows 10. Its server sibling, Windows Server 2016, was released in September 2016. In Q1 2015, Microsoft was the third largest maker of mobile phones, selling 33 million units, 72% of all, while a large majority, at least 75% of them, do not run any version of Windows Phone. Those other phones are not categorized as smartphones by Gartner. In the same time frame, 8 million Windows smartphones. 25% of all smartphones were made by all manufacturers, but mostly by Microsoft. Microsoft's share of the US smartphone market in January 2016 was 27%. On March 1, 2016, Microsoft announced the merger of its PC and Xbox divisions, with Phil Spencer announcing that Universal Windows applications would be the focus for Microsoft's gaming in the future. Services. In June 2016, Microsoft announced a project named Microsoft Azure Information Protection. It aims to help enterprises protect their data as it moves between servers and devices. In July 2016, Microsoft launched a series of classes in data science through EdZorg, the nonprofit online learning destination founded by Harvard University and MIT. The data science curriculum is the first offering of the Microsoft Professional Degree Program, a Microsoft-led initiative to help professionals grow their skills in critical fields. Businesses. This section needs to be updated. Please update this article to reflect recent events or newly available information. January 2015 Windows Division, Server and Tools, Online Services Division. Toronto Microsoft Store. The company's client division produces the flagship Windows OS line, such as Windows 8. It also produces the Windows Live family of products and services. Server and Tools produces the server versions of Windows, such as Windows Server 2008 R2, as well as a set of development tools called Microsoft Visual Studio, Microsoft Silverlight, a web application framework, and System Center Configuration Manager, a collection of tools providing remote control abilities, patch management, software distribution, and a hardware-software inventory. Other server products include Microsoft SQL Server, a relational database management system, Microsoft Exchange Server, for certain business-oriented email and scheduling features, Small Business Server, for messaging and other small business-oriented features, and Microsoft BizTalk Server, for business process management. Microsoft provides IT consulting, Microsoft Consulting Services, and produces a set of Certification programs handled by the Server and Tools Division designed to recognize individuals who have a minimal set of proficiencies in a specific role. This includes developers, Microsoft Certified Solution Developer, System Network Analysts, Microsoft Certified Systems Engineer, Trainers, Microsoft Certified Trainers, and Administrators, Microsoft Certified Systems Administrator, and Microsoft Certified Database Administrator. Microsoft Press, which publishes books, is also managed by the division. The Online Services Business Division handles the online service MSN and the search engine Bing. Business Division Microsoft Tallow, the headquarters of Microsoft Mobile. The Microsoft Business Division produces Microsoft Office, including Microsoft Office 2016, the company's line of Office software. The software product includes Word, a word processor, Access, a relational database program, Excel, a spreadsheet program, Outlook groupware, frequently used with Exchange Server, PowerPoint presentation software, Publisher Desktop Publishing Software, and SharePoint. A number of other products were added later with the release of Office 2003, including Visio, Project, MapPoint, InfoPath, and OneNote. The division also develops enterprise resource planning ERP software for companies under the Microsoft Dynamics brand. These include Microsoft Dynamics AX, Microsoft Dynamics Nav, Microsoft Dynamics GP, and Microsoft Dynamics SL. They are targeted at varying company types and countries, and limited to organizations with under 7,500 employees. Also included under the Dynamics brand is the customer relationship management software Microsoft Dynamics CRM, part of the Azure Services Platform Entertainment and Devices Division. See also, Microsoft Mobile. The Entertainment and Devices Division produces the Windows CE OS for embedded systems and Windows Phone for smartphones. Microsoft initially entered the mobile market through Windows CE for handheld devices, eventually developing into the Windows Mobile OS, and now, Windows Phone. Windows CE is designed for devices where the OS may not directly be visible to the end user, in particular, appliances and cars. The division also produces computer games, via its in-house game publisher Microsoft Studios, that run on Windows PCs and other systems, including titles such as Age of Empires, Halo, and the Microsoft Flight Simulator series, and houses the Macintosh business unit, which produces macOS software, including Microsoft Office 2011 for Mac. Microsoft's Entertainment and Devices Division designs, markets, and manufactures consumer electronics, including the Xbox 360 game console, the handheld Zune media player, and the television-based internet appliance MSN TV. Microsoft also markets personal computer hardware, including mice, keyboards, and various game controllers such as joysticks and gamepads. Future Decoded. Future Decoded is a business networking event held every year by Microsoft that allows business partners of the company to share their views on what the future holds for business, society, leadership, and technology. Corporate affairs. See also, criticism of Microsoft Board of Directors. The company is run by a board of directors made up of mostly company outsiders, as is customary for publicly traded companies. Members of the board of directors as of January 2016 are John W. Thompson, Bill Gates, Terry L. List Stoll, Mason Morphy, Satya Nadella, Charles Noska, Helmut Panka, Sandy Peterson, Charles W. Scharf, John W. Stanton, and Padmasree Warrior. Board members are elected every year at the annual shareholders meeting using a majority vote system. There are five committees within the board which oversee more specific matters. These committees include the Audit Committee, which handles accounting issues with the company including auditing and reporting, the Compensation Committee, which approves compensation for the CEO and other employees of the company, the Finance Committee, which handles financial matters such as proposing mergers and acquisitions, the Governance and Nominating Committee, which handles various corporate matters including nomination of the board, and the Antitrust Compliance Committee, which attempts to prevent company practices from violating antitrust laws. Financial 5-year history graph of NASDAQ. Apple Inc. surpassed Microsoft in Q1 2011 quarterly profits and revenues due to a slowdown in PC sales and continuing huge losses in Microsoft's Online Services Division, which contains its search engine Bing. Microsoft profits were $52 billion, while Apple Inc. profits were $6 billion, on revenues of $145 billion and $247 billion respectively. Microsoft's Online Services Division has been continuously loss-making since 2006. 2006 and in Q1 2011 it lost $726 million. This follows a loss of $25 billion for the year 2010 on July 20, 2012. Microsoft posted its first quarterly loss ever, despite earning record revenues for the quarter and fiscal year, with a net loss of $492 million due to a write-down related to the advertising company Aquantive, which had been acquired for $62 billion back in 2007. As of January 2014, Microsoft's market capitalization stood at $314 billion, making it the eighth largest company in the world by market capitalization on November 14, 2014. Microsoft overtook ExxonMobil to become the second most valuable company by market capitalization, behind only Apple Inc. Its total market value was over $410 billion. Microsoft press event at E3 Expo 2012 Windows 8 launch event in Akihabara, Tokyo on October 25, 2012. In 2004, Microsoft commissioned research firms to do independent studies comparing the total cost of ownership TCO of Windows Server 2003 to Linux. The firms concluded that companies found Windows easier to administrate than Linux, thus those using Windows would administrate faster, resulting in lower costs for their company, i.e. lower TCO. This spurred a wave of related studies. A study by the Yankee Group concluded that upgrading from one version of Windows Server to another costs a fraction of the switching costs from Windows Server to Linux, although companies surveyed noted the increased security and reliability of Linux servers and concern about being locked into using Microsoft products. Another study, released by the Open Source Development Labs, claimed that the Microsoft studies were simply outdated and one-sided, and their survey concluded that the TCO of Linux was lower due to Linux administrators managing more servers on average and other reasons. As part of the Get the Facts campaign, Microsoft highlighted the net trading platform that it had developed in partnership with Accenture for the London Stock Exchange, claiming that it provided 5-9s reliability after suffering extended downtime and unreliability. The LSE announced in 2009 that it was planning to drop its Microsoft solution and switch to a Linux-based one in 2010. In 2012, Microsoft hired a political pollster named Mark Penn, whom the New York Times called famous for bulldozing his political opponents as executive vice president, advertising and strategy. Penn created a series of negative ads targeting one of Microsoft's chief competitors, Google. The ads, called Scroogled, attempt to make the case that Google is screwing consumers with search results rigged to favor Google's paid advertisers, that Gmail violates the privacy of its users to place ad results related to the content of their emails, and shopping results which favor Google products. Tech publications like TechCrunch have been highly critical of the ad campaign, while Google employees have embraced it. Layoffs. Main article, criticism of Microsoft. In July 2014, Microsoft announced plans to lay off 18,000 employees. Microsoft employed 127,104 people as of June 5, 2014, making this about a 14% reduction of its workforce, as the biggest Microsoft layoff ever. This included 12,500 professional and factory personnel. Previously, Microsoft has laid off 5,800 jobs in 2009 in line with U.S. financial crisis. In September 2014, Microsoft laid off 2,100 people, including 747 people in the Seattle-Redmond area, where the company is headquartered. The firings came as a second wave of the layoffs that were previously announced. This brings the total number to over 15,000 out of the 18,000 expected cuts in October 2014. Microsoft revealed that it was almost done with the elimination of 18,000 employees, which was its largest ever layoff sweep. In July 2015, Microsoft announced another 7,800 job cuts in the next several months. In May 2016, Microsoft announced another 1,850 job cuts, mostly in Nokia mobile phone division. As a result, the company will record an impairment and restructuring charge of approximately $950 million, of which approximately $200 million will relate to severance payments. United States Government. Main article, criticism of Microsoft. Microsoft provides information about reported bugs in their software to intelligence agencies of the United States government. Prior to the public release of the fix, a Microsoft spokesperson has stated that the corporation runs several programs that facilitate the sharing of such information with the U.S. government. Following media reports about PRISM, NSA's massive electronic surveillance program, in May 2013, several technology companies were identified as participants, including Microsoft Microsoft. According to leaks of said program, Microsoft joined the PRISM program in 2007. However, in June 2013, an official statement from Microsoft flatly denied their participation in the program. "We provide customer data only when we receive a legally binding order or subpoena to do so, and never on a voluntary basis. In addition, we only ever comply with orders for requests about specific accounts or identifiers if the government has a broader voluntary national security program to gather customer data. We don't participate in it." During the first 6 months in 2013, Microsoft had received requests that affected between 15,000 and 15,999 accounts. In December 2013, the company made statement to further emphasize the fact that they take their customers' privacy and data protection very seriously, even saying that government snooping potentially now constitutes an advanced persistent threat, alongside sophisticated malware and cyber attacks. The statement also marked the beginning of a three-part program to enhance Microsoft's encryption and transparency efforts on July 1, 2014. As part of this program, they opened the first of many Microsoft Transparency Center that provides participating governments with the ability to review source code for our key products, assure themselves of their software integrity, and confirm there are no backdoors. Microsoft has also argued that the United States Congress should enact strong privacy regulations to protect consumer data. In 2016, the company sued the U.S., arguing that secrecy orders were preventing the company from disclosing warrants to customers in violation of the company's and customers' rights. Corporate identity, corporate culture. The Commons, located on the campus of the company's headquarters in Redmond, technical reference for developers and articles for various Microsoft magazines such as Microsoft Systems Journal MSJ are available through the Microsoft Developer Network MSDN. MSDN also offers subscriptions for companies and individuals, and the more expensive subscriptions usually offer access to pre-release beta versions of Microsoft software. In April 2004, Microsoft launched a community site for developers and users, titled Channel 9, that provides a wiki and an internet forum. Another community site that provides daily videocasts and other services, Antennet, launched on March 3, 2006. Free technical support is traditionally provided through online Usenet newsgroups, and CompuServe. In the past, monitored by Microsoft employees, there can be several newsgroups for a single product. Helpful people can be elected by peers or Microsoft employees for Microsoft Most Valuable Professional MVP status, which entitles them to a sort of special social status and possibilities for awards and other benefits. Noted for its internal lexicon, the expression "eating our own dog food" is used to describe the policy of using pre-release and beta versions of products inside Microsoft in an effort to test them in real-world situations. This is usually shortened to just dog food and is used as noun, verb, and adjective. Another bit of jargon, FYIFV or FYIV, fuck you, I'm vested, is used by an employee to indicate they are financially independent and can avoid work anytime they wish. The company is also known for its hiring process, mimicked in other organizations and dubbed the Microsoft interview, which is notorious for off-the-wall questions such as, why is a manhole cover round? Microsoft is an outspoken opponent of the cap on H-1B visas, which allow companies in the U.S. to employ certain foreign workers. Bill Gates claims the cap on H-1B visas makes it difficult to hire employees for the company, stating, "I'd certainly get rid of the H-1B cap." In 2005, critics of H-1B visas argue that relaxing the limits would result in increased unemployment for U.S. citizens due to H-1B workers working for lower salaries. The Human Rights Campaign Corporate Equality Index, a report of how progressive the organization deems company policies towards LGBT, lesbian, gay, bisexual and transsexual employees, rated Microsoft as 87% from 2002 to 2004 and as 100% from 2005 to 2010 after they allowed gender expression environment. In 2011, Greenpeace released a report rating the top 10 big brands in cloud computing on their sources of electricity for their data centers. At the time, data centers consumed up to 2% of all global electricity, and this amount was projected to increase. Phil Radford of Greenpeace said, "We are concerned that this new explosion in electricity use could lock us into old, polluting energy sources instead of the clean energy available today," and called on Amazon, Microsoft and other leaders of the information technology industry must embrace clean energy to power their cloud-based data centers. In 2013, Microsoft agreed to buy power generated by a Texas wind project to power one of its data centers. Microsoft is ranked on The 17th place in Greenpeace's Guide to Greener Electronics 16th edition that ranks 18 electronics manufacturers according to their policies on toxic chemicals, recycling and climate change. Microsoft's timeline for phasing out brominated flame retardant BFRs and phthalate in all products is 2012, but its commitment to phasing out PVC is not clear as of January 2011. It has no products that are completely free from PVC and BFRs. Microsoft's main U.S. campus received a silver certification from the Leadership in Energy and Environmental Design LEED program in 2008, and it installed over 2,000 solar panels on top of its buildings in its Silicon Valley campus, generating approximately 15% of the total energy needed by the facilities in April 2005. Microsoft makes use of alternative forms of transit. It created one of the world's largest private bus systems, the Connector, to transport people from outside the company. For on-campus transportation, the Shuttle Connect uses a large fleet of hybrid cars to save fuel. The company also subsidizes regional public transport, provided by Sound Transit and King County Metro, as an incentive in February 2010. However, Microsoft took a stance against adding additional public transport and high-occupancy vehicle HOV lanes to the State Route 520 and its floating bridge connecting Redmond to Seattle. The company did not want to delay the construction any further. Microsoft was ranked number one in the list of the world's best multinational workplaces by the Great Place to Work Institute in 2011. Headquarters Microsoft European HQ. Book and Surface Pro 4. Notably, the second floor has a large area designated for consumers to play Xbox games. The third floor has been named the Dell Experience at the Microsoft Store, which showcases various Dell products. The fourth floor is for employees and administrative operations. The fifth floor has been designed as a pseudo-conference center, as it will hold events and meetings. On November 12, 2015, Microsoft opened a second flagship store, located in Sydney's Pitt Street Mall. The two-story, 6,000 square feet location features Microsoft's flagship products, including the Surface line and Xbox One. There is also an answer desk on site for customers to get product support. Logo. Microsoft adopted the so-called Pac-Man logo, designed by Scott Baker. In 1987, Baker stated, "The new logo, in Helvetica italic typeface, has a slash between the O and S to emphasize the soft part of the name and convey motion and speed." Dave Norris ran an internal joke campaign to save the old logo, which was green, in all uppercase, and featured a fanciful letter O, nicknamed the Blibbit, but it was discarded. Microsoft's logo with the tagline, "Your potential, our passion." Exchange Conference in 2010, Microsoft unveiled the company's next tagline, "Be What's Next." They also had a slogan, tagline, "Making it all make sense." On August 23, 2012, Microsoft unveiled a new corporate logo at the opening of its 23rd Microsoft store in Boston, indicating the company's shift of focus from the classic style to the tile-centric modern interface, which it uses, will use on the Windows Phone platform, Xbox 360, Windows 8 and the upcoming Office suites. The new logo also includes four squares with the colors of the then-current Windows logo, which have been used to represent Microsoft's four major products, Windows Blue, Office Red, Xbox Green and Bing Yellow. The logo resembles the opening of one of the commercials for Windows 95, 1975, 1980, 1980, 1982, 1982, 1987, 1987, 2012, 2012 present. 1975-1980, first Microsoft logo, in 1975, 1980, 1982, second Microsoft logo, in 1980, 1982, 1987, third Microsoft logo, in 1982, 1987, 2012, Microsoft Pac-Man logo, designed by Scott Baker and used from 1987 to 2012 present, fifth Microsoft logo, introduced on August 23, 2012. Sponsorship. The company was the official jersey sponsor of Finland's national basketball team at the 2015 Eurobasket. The company sponsored the Lotus F1 team as Microsoft Dynamics. See also Bill Gates, Paul Allen. List of mergers and acquisitions by Microsoft. Microsoft Portal, Xbox Portal, Information Technology Portal Companies Portal, Seattle Portal, United States Portal. References. Brad Smith, Microsoft. Carrot ABCDE, Earnings Release FY16 Q4, Microsoft July 21, 2016, retrieved July 19, 2016. Blog May 10, 2011, retrieved April 4, 2011. Publishing ISBN. Computer source archived from the original on September 1, 2006, retrieved July 14, 2010. Today. IT proportal retrieved April 4, 2012. 2010.